Hey, people, welcome. I like dinosaurs, avian or non-avian. They're just so cool and diverse. They have so many different lifestyles, body types, and vibes. Everybody has their faves, whether it's T-Rex, Ankylosaurus, Velociraptor, Triceratops, or geese. But my favorite non-avian dinosaurs would either have to be the controversial Spinosaurus or the very unusual Carnotaurus. However, today, I have decided to draw a remarkably large Carnotaurus being pet by a person. Yes, despite what movies and shows may tell you, not all dinosaurs are super large behemoths that can eat everyone you've ever loved. Carnotaurus is actually pretty small, but they can probably still pose a threat to you. But this Carnotaurus, despite its absurd size, is a really friendly bloke. I was inspired by a verse which talks about how when sin is expunged, everyone will finally give peace a chance. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf, and the lion, and the fattened calf together, and a little child shall lead them. Isaiah 11:6. I know that there aren't any mentions of dinosaurs within these verses, but I thought, dinosaurs are God's creations, why shouldn't they share all the world with us? Lions and snakes will. So I went and made this. I don't really have much to say about this picture in of itself. It's pretty easy to understand what it means, but you can interpret it however you want. With that being said, I'm thinking about experimenting with different art styles. The one that I'm currently painting in is good, I enjoy doing it, but I feel a bit stagnant and stuck. I've been kind of drawn to some unconventional stuff. I did some research on Dadaism and other anti-art movements in the past, and I find them very intriguing. I kind of want to dabble in that and to maybe talk about the gospel through it or something. I'm not sure where I'll go with it or if I'll even stick with it. I might make videos on my process and what it means to me, but I don't necessarily want to go into too much detail. I know that most of us would rather stay where we are, but I want a chance to expand, to be more disruptive. I feel like my work is too safe sometimes. There's nothing wrong with chill art. I like to make stuff for fun sometimes, and people like Thomas Kincaid were able to make a fortune making art that's really serene. But I want to experiment. The thing that really kickstarted this was a post made by one of those traditional, beauty, aesthetic, borderline Nazi accounts. They were talking about the degradation of art and comparing a random foot from a sculpture to urinal by Marcel Duchamp. I've seen so many people complain about this toilet. I finally decided to look into it, and to my surprise, that toilet is actually over 100 years old, and it still gets a strong reaction out of people. The whole point of this work was to make fun of the way we see art, and people's responses to it are only proving his point. That's when I realized that maybe there could be more to artistic expression than simply painting pretty pictures. I hate how homogenous and boring a lot of Christian music is on the radio, so why should I fall into that trap of being a one-trick pony? I hope that someday I'll make something that'll give people such a visceral reaction, even long after my death. I wanted to glorify God too, of course. And no, before you ask, I'm not going to be sending in objects to art galleries, but I will be trying different methods of art. I hope you all stick around for my artistic journey. I also make videos to help Christian artists improve their work. I'm by no means an expert, but I have gained a lot of knowledge with the help of the Lord. If you want to support me and what I do, I'm selling a print of the painting you see here at my shop, which you can get by clicking the link in the description. Anyway, thanks for listening and watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.